Okay, guys, I'm back, and last episode we built the church. I just realised the roof doesn't quite look right. Let me just fix that. Bugger. Let's get a living half block as well, don't I? There we go. So now I'm going to build the stonemason, and I'm not sure whether to have it close to the town or far away. I'm going to have it close, but just to let you guys know, in the future, there will be... I'm making more of this feature, more out of the mine, stuff like that, because obviously the stonemason needs enough stone to be masoning with. Now, a stonemason's yard doesn't actually need to consist of much, because it's pretty much just where the stonemason works. Not where he works, because he works on site, so it's more where he stores his stuff. So it's going to be very simple. It's going to be an area like, I might actually use this. Okay, the stonemason is going to be out the back of this house, so I'm going to clear away this. Stop raining. Let's go. Bit too much there. Right, and now let's take our wand and make sure we don't cut off the fireplace or anything. Come out to here. That. And then select from here to here. No. Almost got rid of my fireplace there. No, damn it! Ugh, penis. Alright. No, I shouldn't have buggered up the fireplace at all. Oh, wait, that's not right. Go away. I'm not supposed to be here. Now, I do need to flatten out all this area, but I'll do it later. Oh, are you hearing that clicking, man? Like a click monster. Oh, what am I doing? There we go. And this is obviously going to be fenced off. He's going to have his own little gate here, so that he can go and get the stuff from over there. So I'll do a little gravel path, but not right now, can't be asked. And see, he can get through here. Okay, so he can just walk straight through here into his stone yard. Considering changing all this to gravel. Yeah, I'm going to change all this to gravel. I don't want lots of cobblestone everywhere. Oh no. I was actually going to leave that and then I realised that I can do it. Damn it. Okay. So, there's our little gravel floor and we're going to take some cobblestone. I've already got some cobblestone. And we're just going to pile it up into nice little stacks of 4x4. I, of course, do not mean 4. I mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 stacks of 8. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. Oh dear. Okay, so here's the stonemasons. I'm also gonna, just for aesthetics, and we'll do some stuff like this. Maybe he's started to turn these into normal bricks and he's got some half built ones around like here and here and here. And does the cracks kind of look like they're only half built? If you see what I'm getting at. So there is the stonemason's yard where he's building his stone. And the stonemason lives. Oh, I do need to build some more houses, don't I? Need some more housing. Let me think whether I should do that now or leave it a little bit. Alright, let's look at our population a second. So we've got household number one, which I've moved over there, but whatever. House number one has three people in it. I'm going to need to keep tally, otherwise I will lose count. Ugh. What the fuck is that? What the hell is that doing on my desk? Meh. Okay, so that's three people. Oh, what? No, what is that? Fuck off. Right, three people, and then household number two contains two people. And then household number three, so that's five. I just thought I'd note that. That's not household. That one contains four, so that's five plus four, which is nine. See, I did do maths. That one contains one. That's pretty useless, so that's 10. And the fishing house contains one, so that's 11. And the other cottage contains one, so that's 12. So we have 12 residents. Now, let's think about this. So we've got 12 people. Say, three miners. Two farmers. One person who's also a priest. Okay, the fisherman's also the priest. Let's just say that, because the fisherman can't fish all day, get bored. Don't they? So one fisherman. One miller. Someone who mills all the bread and cooks all that up. One hauler. Right, let's see how many that is. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we've only used up 7 people in our population. Say we'd need 3 people to look after kids. 7, 8, and 10. And 2 kids. Oh, you wouldn't need 3 people to look after 2 kids, would you? Okay, we've got one old person, 2 kids, and 1 nanny. And that brings us up to our 12. So, we've actually filled up our population with all the houses we have now. So, we will need some more housing. Right, let me explain the kind of dilemma I'm in at the moment. You see this house, okay? This is actually, compared to the rest of the village, if you look at the size of things, right, there's the church, there's the mill and stuff like that. This is a big house. Okay, it's probably almost the same surface area as the barn. Okay, so this is a big house. But it's not a big house, is it? Look at it. It's a tiny house. This is the big struggle that I'm going to have with this settlement. I'm going to have a huge problem turning these small, if I wanted to build, someone had the suggestion of building a small multi-roomed house, and I'd really like to do that, but it's gonna have to be about twice the size of this. It's gonna be huge. It's gonna tower above the rest of it. It's gonna look like a freaking huge mansion compared to the rest of the houses. So I don't really know what to do. Shut up. Where's my phone? Fuck off. Go away. I hate it. I really, really hate it when the phone does that. I don't know why. It just like pierces my eardrum. It's still doing it! Go away. Ugh. Oh, that just made it worse. Come on. Oh, I guess that helps. Okay, so, I don't know what to do. I'm just going to build some more cottages. I'm going to build a nice semi-detached house somewhere. I know it's going to go here. I'm going to have a row here, a street, which I'm going to put lots of houses on. So I will do that I won't build the whole row, obviously, but I'll put the street in anyway. Perhaps 2 bricks wide. There we go. It's got a lot of cobblestone in it now, this settlement. Right, so one of our houses is going to go here. Right, so it's going to be wooden construction. It's going to have... Oh, I don't think I actually said that before. Yeah, I've changed the thatch texture to sponge. Yeah, see, look, you can hear, that's now the sponge texture. So I can put it, look, if I come over here and do this, it won't catch fire anymore. So whoever's idea that was, good idea. It doesn't even matter for that, because there's not actually a fire in there, I just realised. Okay, so let's build this house and stop faffing about. It's going to be a semi-detached house, so it's got to be quite long. It's going to have doorway number one there, and doorway number two there. And say about this deep. Yep. This is going to house a lot of people. It's going to be like the kind of council house of the settlement. Right. It's also going to be two stories, and I'm going to try as hard. You're going to go down into it. So the. Basically, the aim of this house is to make as much space as humanly possible out of a smaller area. And we shall see how I do that. Now, I'm not going to start building things out of like stone yet, just because I don't really want to progress time that fast, because I quite like building out of these materials. So this is going to be a timber construction or whitewash? Whitewash. It's going to be a whitewash. Whitewash construction. Okay, so when you go down into it, the steps are actually going to be on the street. I got a bit of a lisp there, didn't I? Street. Where's the stairs? There they go. So you're going to walk down into it. And we're going to have a wooden skirting board. Actually, I want to make it out of this wood. Not all the way around, just where the windows will be. Because I really hate seeing that at the bottom of a window. I don't know why, it just bugs me. Okay, that's cool. It's going to be made out of whitewash, which is this. Or, oh, I don't know which one to use. Alright, I'm going to make it out of whitewash, because when I change the texture pack a little bit, it will look a lot more rustic and a lot better. Too OCD, I can't have this. So we've all got to be the same. There we go. Right, so let's take our light blue wool, which isn't light blue, obviously, and build this. I'm just going to basically dirty up this texture a little bit and it will look okay, hopefully. Will that actually work? No, it won't. Okay, so it needs, the steps need to come back further then. I know what I'll do. Yeah, that's cool. God, I'm a genius. So you'll come in here and the door will open inwards. Let's take our doors, put those in. There you go. Now, alright, let's make the bottom floor made out of cobblestone then. The skirting board looks weird as hell. But I get, actually that's quite realistic. No, that is quite realistic, I'm going to leave it as hell. Leave it as hell? Leave it as is. I'm going to use the floorboards as the floor. These ones, because again I'm going to alter these a little bit in the texture pack, so they will look a lot nicer. Even if they don't quite look right at the moment. Okay. Now, this is going to be our second floor, and it's going to go Okay, let's build up this a little bit. I'm going to think about this in terms of the roof. I'm just going to see what this looks like. I think that looks good. It's raining again. God damn it. Yeah, I think that's quite a nice cottage I designed, actually. What about if I did that? Make it even smaller window. Yeah, that does actually look very cottagey. We'll see what it looks like when it's got its end wall and stuff on there. Now the end wall will be very simple, just like this. And we can have a nice square window in there. That'll look good. So let's go along. Let's finish all this off. Right, so this will be like this. Dun 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 dun. Fail, fail, fail. God damn it. Nope. I'll get that. I really build way too fast. Like, I just end up missing all the blocks because I'm clicking so quick. I actually did that in photography the other day. I had a lot of photos that I'd edited before I went on holiday, and I went to show the teacher them, and I literally just pressed delete because I thought it was a different folder. And I don't know if you've ever used a school computer. Especially in my school, you don't have control of, like, you're not an administrator account, obviously. So if you delete something, that's it. It's gone. I was really annoyed. She didn't believe me. She thought I was lying. She thought I just hadn't done it because she's not the most computer person. Computer person. Not the most technologically aware teacher I've ever had. I've had worse. Right, let's have a look at this from the front then. Yeah, I'm actually really happy with this. What about if I do that? No. There we go. Have a little ground window. We actually had ground windows. Yeah. It's weird because when you build something completely out of white, it usually looks terrible, but it actually looks quite nice. I like setting things into the floor quite a lot. Right, so let's think about these stairs then. I just had an idea. I'm not sure if it'll work. Yep, it's going to work. Hell yeah. Right, bear with me. A lot of these kind of houses actually did have outside staircases, because they didn't have enough room on the inside, which is exactly the situation I'm in. What am I doing? Oh, no! No! No, I can't get rid of that base of roof. My OCD will, like, kill me. Alright, what if I just do this, then? Will that actually work? Yeah. About that. I guess that'll have to do. No, that looks weird. Damn it. Damn you, bit of roof. Fuck you. I can't move that door across one block. Oh, everything was so perfect. No, it's weird. It's got to be flush with the building. Oh, that's so annoying. That is so annoying. How can I get around this? Maybe if you just jump from the side. Oh no, you can't actually walk up the stairs. Oh my god, this is so annoying. What about... I can't put it at the back. It's got to be on the side, hasn't it? Fuck's sake. No! Oh! Fuck you! No, I really don't want to do that. No, I suppose that could work. No, I tell you what I'll do. I know what I'll do. I'll just have a little balcony and bring it out here. Like that. And then that will work. Awesome. I should probably actually have that going across, shouldn't I? Sorry, I've got. I just went silent because I got completely sidetracked by building that. But yeah, that went really well. I'm really happy with that. Okay, so let's think about windowing and furnishing then. I'm going to use glass panes because they are nice, versatile window sizes. Can I do that? No, I can't do that, can I? What about if I did this? I don't know, I think I preferred it without. Yeah, I prefer it without. Don't need windows there. Okay. You walk into the house. Got window there, window there. There's not very many windows. Can't even click on those. And upstairs, I'm thinking whether I can make those windows higher. I think I should. What about if I do that? No, that'll look weird. No. There we go. Sorry, I haven't spoken much this episode. I've just been, I am really happy with that. You know, last episode I was moaning about not being able to make, actually it might have been this episode, I don't even know, about making houses like this bigger, but I've actually just made a house cape, you know, it feels quite big inside that house. Obviously it doesn't feel that big because it's on the inside it's like shit and tiny, but I mean, like, I can fit quite a few, right, let's think about it. Let's fit as many people as we possibly can into this house without it being ridiculously cramped. So let's have chairs. I'll help with the chairs. We shall have tables made out of pressure plates and stairs. Not stairs. Fences. And what else can we have in the house? Well, we're going to need furnaces so I can cook. Oh, bugger, I completely forgot about chimney. I know. Never mind. I'm going to have one big shared chimney right out the middle with shared furnaces. What else have we got then? Try out some bookshelves because they're starting to think a bit more vanity-like. We need some workbenches and some chests. Perfect. Right. So this upstairs is actually going to house two people. They can have one shared chest between them. Okay, actually, ooh, if we can fit, so what I could do is I could make this one house, like I could probably fit enough stuff in here for one house. Probably only for one person though, pushing, two people would be pushing it a little bit. And I could have another house downstairs. I forgot about this glass now. So I could have, or I could have one house down here and one completely separate house up here, or I could just make it the downstairs like a utility area and the upstairs have all the stuff in it. In fact, I'm going to do both. Okay, I'm going to do both. This area, this house on the right, is actually just going to be, because it will look nicer, it's going to be, hold on, sorry, can't talk and think. Right, this is going to be one house, so I'm actually going to have stairs going up the inside here. Right, and it's going to have a bed there, alright, a double bed. I think I could probably save a bit more space. Let's put that there. That there. That there. Then we have a bookshelf there. Furnace there. Where's the smoke going to go? I've been really good about my chimneys so far. Okay, this is like horrible. Okay, I'm gonna leave it as that because it works. But don't worry, guys. If this is like making you really annoyed by the way I've done that, then don't worry, it's making me annoyed as well. There's gonna be a bedside cabinet there, table even, cabinet. What the fuck am I? I could put a chair there. No, that's stupid. That's a stupid idea. I don't have room for a double bed. Okay, it's going to be a single bed. But not necessarily for one person. Okay, two people sleep in that single bed. They get on very well together. They just cuddle. It's sickeningly cute, really. Now let's have our kitchen worktop will go like that. Will it? I don't know. Damn it. And we can have a table and a chair there. Oh, that looks shit. Oh well. Can't be fucked sorting out stupid little lighting bugs which shouldn't be in the game anyway. Let's have a thing there. I'm actually going to. Workbench, there we go. And upstairs they can have a light up there and light up there. Right, cool. And then their light can go there. No, that's crap. But here, here, and here. Now this one is going to be for two people. No, four people. This is going to be like the real slummy place. They're going to have a workbench and a chest. Where's the chest? There it is. They're not even going to have a chest each, that's how shitty this place is. And they've got their little fire there. Okay, they do have a chest each now. There's the workbench. Okay, so an absolute shithole. But it houses them, so they can shut up and stop moaning. And exactly the same get up out over here. Doesn't even matter that this isn't symmetrical. With a workbench here. And I do need to have a furnace going up. Where is it? There it is. Okay, so there's upstairs furnaces, so this is a completely separate house, and I need to give it some lighting. Okay, cool. I'm happy with this. I need to do something about this. What can I do? Okay, so there's my cottage finished. I'm going to leave this episode here because I've been doing it for ages. Next episode, I need to rebuild a farm, and what I'm probably going to do is level out this whole area here so that I can expand quite a lot over there. I still need to do that bridge, and as soon as the bridge is done, then I can start on this market area because this area of cobblestone is looking pretty ugly. But before I build the market, I think I'm going to build a fountain. Ooh, I don't know. No, well, I'll build the market and then see if it still needs a fountain. There will be a fountain at some point. I also need to do this path leading up to the bridge. And yeah, so I'll see you guys soon.